the final assembly. Here is where all the parts come together to create the Colt 1911 handgun. First, the slide is lubricated at key points. Then the barrel and barrel bushing are installed. Next are the recoil spring and spring guide. Then the receiver is mated to the slide. The slide stop is inserted through the frame, securing the slide, barrel, and frame together. Next is the recoil spring plug secured by the barrel bushing. The action is checked, and now a file is carefully run through the inside of the frame where the trigger will go. Before installing the trigger bow is checked on a magazine to make sure it's in spec. A magazine is partially inserted and the magazine catch assembly is installed. The travel of the trigger is checked. Next, the hammer and hammer strut are installed and held in place with the hammer pin. The sear and disconnector are properly oriented and installed, being held in place with the firing pin. The sear pin is pushed in place. Next, the sear spring is inserted into the receiver and held in place by the main spring housing. The grip safety is positioned in the receiver, and with a little push, the main spring housing goes to the final position and held in place by the main spring housing pin. The hammer is now cocked and the thumb safety fitted. Pushing the thumb safety to the on position and then removing it reveals where the thumb safety needs minor fitting. A kiss of the file and the safety is ready to be checked again for fit. This is done slowly to make sure the thumb safety is properly fitted and can take a few passes till it is just right. Plunger spring assembly inserted into the plunger tube, the thumb safety is installed. With the gun assembled, a function test is conducted. The assembly complete, a chamber block is inserted into the chamber and the assembler's mark is stamped on the frame. The Colt 1911 is now ready for function testing.